Here at the Center for Nanoproduction and Microanalysis, we are developing catalyst nanomaterials, and we are developing these in collaboration with both the industry and academia. What we typically do is that we collaborate with academia and the industry and demonstrate how you can take some of the great results, some of the great new catalysts developed in the various laboratories and universities, demonstrate how you can upscale this production and make a large-scale production, and then how the industry can utilize this new catalyst materials. So for this purpose, we have developed several reactors, which you can see two of them behind me here. And here what we do is we synthesize the catalyst nanoparticles in a flow, meaning that we are having, for example, metal precursors, metal salts in a solution, pumping them into the system in a flow, heating it up, pressurizing it, and then you develop your catalyst nanoparticles. These particles could be both, for example, metal oxides or pure metal particles. We have some examples here where you see various metal oxides. And then what you get out is these nanoparticles in a suspension or in a solution. This solution you can then further process, and you can create, for example, slurries. These are also particles in a suspension, but with a very high dry content. These slurries are typically made for exhaust systems. So what we make a catalyst structure which are utilized for diesel trucks to remove, for example, soot or some carbon monoxide. You make the nanoparticles, you make the slurry, and then you deposit it on your substrate. This is for a heavy diesel truck, or we also test it at lab scale at smaller structures. So that is one area where we work within. We're also working within fuel cell catalyst. Here we are producing methyl nanoparticles, for example, platinum, and we are producing these on carbon nanoparticles. We are pumping both methyl salts and carbon nanoparticles into the system, where we're then developing the platinum on the carbon or various platinum alloys. And this is to be used for electrodes in fuel cell later on.